Hey everybody, it's Road Rash at Cranium. This is, first I'd like to apologize and say I'm sorry to everybody for being so long and making a video. I have been super busy with a lot of crap. First things, I'm sure a lot of you remember the video, I effing lost it, where my neighbor, crazy inbred psycho pig fucker, that teases my dog all the time, and we had a couple confrontations. He's actually been stalking me for about 8 years, following me all over town and trying to instigate shit. And I would just ignore him and let it go until I got my dog. And when I got my dog, he started teasing my dog. So my dog hates him. And so every time he sees him, we have a confrontation. And he puts himself in places where I can't avoid him and I have to have a confrontation. So anyway, I made that video of I fucking lost it. And you heard me yelling at him and him yelling at me. Well, about 3 weeks ago, as I was coming home in the morning, it was probably about 8 or 9 in the morning, walking buddy, the inbred psycho fucker was standing in my driveway, waiting for me. And I got up there and he started cussing at me and calling me names. And of course, I gave it right back. And he ended up pulling a gun on me and threatening to kill me and all this other shit. One of my neighbors seen it, came out, and the only reason I didn't get shot, I think, is because he seen my neighbor come out. And so he took off down the road and called the cops and everything. So anyways, I've had a lot of court shit going on. I've had this psycho fuck to deal with. And a lot of hospital stuff with the health issues and shit. So I apologize for not keeping my videos up to date. And I also, I'm on an island and I lost my internet where I'm at. So that's also a hindrance. I do apologize. Things are finally starting to mellow out again, and hopefully I'll be able to start making some more videos and getting back into the groove of things. It was pretty extreme. I can't stand pussies that can't back up the bullshit without a gun. You know, he can't fucking fight me like a man. He can talk all this shit, but when you confront him with it, he's got to pull a gun because he's a fucking pussy. So whatever, you know, he's went to court and all this other crap, and they basically let him go because he gives the judge blowjobs in recess, I guess. And so yeah, it was a total farce, kangaroo court thing. I basically stormed out of court, told the judge this was total horse shit, which it was. And my lawyer actually got up and said to the judge, so you'd rather have two guys walking around Langley, which is a very small town, armed to the teeth and wanting to kill each other, rather than just squashing it right here in the court. And that's exactly what he did. He let us walk out and didn't care what happened after that. So, yeah, him and the judge are buddies. They're both Langley homeowners, and it was a total farce. So I ended up getting him trespassed from this property. He won't be able to come on this property and harass me anymore, so that's cool. What's going to happen next, I don't know. The guy's a total fucking psycho, and he's obviously hot for me or something because he just can't leave me alone. He's got to follow me around all over the place, and yeah, my neighbor, Abby, thinks he's jealous of what I don't know, but the guy obviously has a thing for me because he can't seem to leave me alone. And anywho, Buddy's doing fine. He got his bath today. Everybody say hi to Bud.
Hey, Bud. Say hi to everybody. Hi to all your fans. Yeah. Sir Budrick, it's your nice bath.
Oh, yeah. He's a good puppy dog. He smells so much better. Yes, he does. I'm a good old boy. I'm a good old boy. Yeah. You saying hi to all your fans, huh? My Freckled Bassett fans. Yeah, the guy was actually attacking my videos in court and everything else. Sent them to the manager of my apartment complex. Tried to get me evicted because I made YouTube videos. That's how fucking mentally retarded this dipshit is, that I would actually be evicted for making YouTube videos. It doesn't even make fucking sense. And, you know, why would you send that to my housing or dude or whatever and try to get me? It's asinine. And so anyways, it's just more shit than I care to talk about right now. But that's part of the reason I haven't been making my videos. But like I said, things are starting to calm down. I'm getting back into the swing of things. So I'll be making some more videos here real soon. Mandela is still in full effect, and I'd just like to touch on this real quick. I don't know, you know, how many people feel this way, but personally, I'm confronted with these Mandela effects every single day. It's just in my face and can't avoid them. And it's, at first it was shocking as hell, and I just couldn't wrap my mind around it, that that's really, these changes are real. This reality is not the one that I came from. Now what's happening is I'm actually feeling accosted by these changes. It's a slap in my face. I feel like whoever did this is putting these effects right in my face just to, you know, to like, you know, slap me in the face with it. And I'm really becoming more angry by it, I think, as time goes on. Not so much baffled and trying to get my head around it. This is really, you know, this really happened. But the fact that it did happen and that we're being lied to every single day still. We get no truth, and it's just so deep. This red pill thing, it's so enlightening. It's a good thing, but it's also, I'm finding it to be extremely daunting sometimes, overwhelming. There's so much to take in, and you got to take it little bit by little bit and just try to digest what you can. But like I said, what's happening with me now, and I don't know if it's happening with anybody else, but I'm starting to feel angry. I'm getting more angry, I guess, the more I have Mandela effects slapped in my face. And people that say, oh, these, you know, it's just bullshit, it's not, you know, people that deny it really piss me off too. I get it that some people just can't wrap their heads around it, some people don't want to, and everything else, but the people that, you know, laugh and scoff at it and think it's not real, it pisses me off. You know, just because you're not affected, you don't want to believe it, whatever, you're too stupid to get it, that's your problem. You know, it's not ours. We people that are affected by it, it can't get any more real. And, you know, we can lead a horse to water, we can tell you guys about it, but we can't make you drink, we can't make you accept that this is real. It's, you know, if it's not real for you, it's not. And I guess, you know, for some people they are affected, some people aren't. Some people are affected and they just don't want to admit it and are in denial, whatever. But like I said, it's more and more, it's like a slap in my face, you know, these effects. I want answers, I want change, and I want power back. I want control of what's going on in my life and the world around me. We people that are affected by Mandela effect, we have none of it. We were put here. We don't know why. We don't know what's going on. These Mandela effects are just asinine. There's so damn many of them, and they're just, I get it, man. Some of them are small. They're just, you know, no big deal. But the fact that they are real and they're there makes it hard to ignore them, especially when they're in your face every day, you know, like the titles of shows that I know for a fact were different, and car emblem, just, you know, little minor shit, but I see it every day, and it's kind of an assault to me, I think. I don't know if anybody else is feeling like that. You're not alone. I'm here too, so we need to stick together. Like I said, I live on an island, so I don't have a lot of people I can talk to about it personally. They just don't want to hear it. So hang in there, folks. Stay strong. Keep looking for answers, and God bless.